Hi friends and friendly subscribers, welcome back to my channel. This is Inner Heal Tarot and today we're going to do silent flip through of this Karma Tarot by Birgit Boland Erfurt from US Game, and I believe it's out of print, and this is the 2011 iteration of the game or the reprint already. And for me, it was quite a beautiful deck to do unboxing, not unboxing, but more like flip through right now, because we are in the harvest moon, we are in a contemplating period of the what are we harvesting this this year, basically the Karma Tarot. So I feel that it's a very good idea to do this right now when I'm filming. It's today is the full moon in Aries. It's a type of new foundation. What do we want to have in our life, in our psyche, in our ego from now on moving forwards, for at least until next year? What kind of a new, this building block foundation we want to have. And this is like, yeah, it's a good deck to connect, I think. So this is like, the Karma Tarot presents a dynamic blend of color, symbolism and phantasmagoric artwork designed to stimulate new ways of examining life. The images in this unique deck portray the creative life at Christiania, a cooperative community of artists and musicians in Copenhagen, Denmark. So I'm so glad I got this deck finally, because normally this deck will sell in eBay or other places for quite exorbitant of a price, but I got it in like price of a new of a new, what do you call it, even mass market deck now operated in this deck, the ones that's deemed really beautiful. So I'm so glad I got this deck right now. With the tarot, it also felt like it's really calling you to work in a certain way and certain time, and it will just come no matter what, and it will come within your budget actually. So from this, I'm really learning on trusting. I trust if I want to work with something or a deck, they will also want to work with me. So I just put on patience, patience energy, and just keep at it, you know. The amount of the budget that I can have for a certain deck is this amount, so it will come. Yeah, okay, but let's just go straight to this flip through. Okay, I will try not to be so silent, because I feel when I'm not too silent, the level of engagement it is higher. So I will try to do commentary. It comes with this little guidebook, little white guidebook, like what it normally did before after pandemic. Now guidebooks are quite more elaborate, which is great, than these little ones, but I accept it anyway, because look at this preserver, the level of keeping it tidy, you know. It's very beautiful, it's like new. Okay, so let's do the flip through. I like that in the magician it's called the juggler instead of the magician, and it's make the deck is quite earthy, because also the notion of a juggler, it's not derive something out of nothing, but it's kind of like juggling what's already happening, what we already have within our disposal, and how do we use it to our advantage right now, you know. I like this magician card. wise woman, also as the priestess, a high priestess. And the empress is Lilith. Look at this, you know. Such a beautiful deck. Osiris as the emperor. The Hierophant. I mean, look at this face, you know. It looks like someone who's... it's not like a really pope in Catholic meaning, but it's more like someone who's actually channeling. Look at the eyes, you know, it's looking at with the third eye. Actually, it's kind of like zone out. And also the hand gesture, it's very Hierophant gesture, but it's also like a, in here I felt it's used as a mudra. You know, when you're working with psychedelics, sometimes if you lock in certain body position or hand gestures, you gain insights in a different level, actually. Look at this. The Hierophant that's working with people that in a karmic cycle with him, you know. So you... When you take a role of a Hierophant or a teacher, you're basically taking a role to also like helping liberate people that you're supposed to teach. Yeah, you're in this karmic game together. Again with the lovers, looks like in a trance. I love this chariot with the eyes, you know. You have to look where you're going. Strength card. Is it in focus? Yeah. Look at the many people down here that's mesmerized by this wheel. It's kind of symbolized also, most people are just very passive and just watching what is going on instead of taking direct action towards the wheel. Hangman with the clown. I love this death because it's similar to the Marseille death. It's beautiful. But it's used with the Rider White Smith connection. Does temperance only work on water? In emotion, temperature in the emotion. The devil. And the Eiffel Tower as the tower. This is so funny. And the star, instead of working with the Sirius star, which is here, but it's also emphasizing working with the moon, which is the emotional body. Look at this moon with these two bottles, you know. Kind of suggesting to me to access the intuition level. Also, it can be helped with the concoction of moonshine, probably. And the sun. Yes, Gabriel. Wow, look at this world card. It's so beautiful as well. The sun and the moon and the earth in harmonious aspect. Start with the King of Swords. I just flipping through as the person before me, how she saw it to me, arranged the card, and I believe she did it as is, as she got it new. This Knight of Swords. Instead of you riding the horse, it's a horse riding you. That is a beautiful cautionary painting there. I love this Eight of Swords because also it has the Saturn in it, and it's showing the city life, city living. And this person is like quite burdened by this, and in result is just like go to the bar and being drunk and feel that I'm stuck, when it's actually you can get out of it anytime you want, right? That's the energy of Eight of Swords. Queen of Wands, the mirror. I love the Six of Cups with the Mona Lisa. I think it's hilarious. Interdimensionality. It's very funny, this horse in the Knight of Coins, but this guy with the ladder, it's resembling to a unicorn staff to me. It's a very interesting painting. Eight of Coins with music. Learning how to hone your way of communicating. It's beautiful. It's also this. It's beautiful the way that this deck convey coins or pentacles, which is like very earthy elements, but they the artist express it in music, which is very ethereal. It's very beautiful energy. Wow, this is a very strong image. Six of Coins. Helping someone giving birth or something. Oof, it's very strong. Five of Coins with Russian roulette, the gambling. Addiction to poor mentality. Feeding addiction. Oof, it's a bit much. Marilyn Monroe like with Four of Coins. Six of Coins. It's the back of the Karma music tarot cards. Okay, so the name of the deck in itself, the full name is not Karma Tarot, it's Karma Music Tarot Cards. So it feels to me that this deck talking about how you talk to yourself through these images, and how do you create reality by talking to yourself. And I'm working with this notion in the last 2-3 months, and I think this is what I'm harvesting now, to work with the self-critic, harsh self-judgment and harsh self-critic. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to work with this deck actually personally. I'm so sorry guys, in the midst of flipping through this deck, I don't know what it is. Probably it's the combination of the cooling down of the jasmine tea that I have, or also the smell of this Saint Eval orange and cinnamon candle. I just start to get dizzy, and now I feel like throwing up, and I felt a little bit sick actually. This deck is definitely evoking something inside me subconsciously that I don't even understand. And they're so visceral, the reaction towards me. It's very go from the visual aspect of things into my gut immediately. So I think I'm going to leave the flip through and the personal take here. Please do let me know if you also already work with this deck. And I think this is the card where the turning point there for me. Maybe I have some of my aspects of personality stuck in this. I have to work with this card later on. But yeah, let me know again, how do you work with this deck if you already work with it. Please do let me know in the comments, and please do like, subscribe and share, because that is the fastest way you can help me and this channel to keep on growing and keep on delivering this type of content if you like them, of course. No, I feel really a bit sick. I have to finish the video now. Thank you so much, guy. I really appreciate your comments. I really love to read them, and the subscribe and like, please. Thank you so much, and see you in the next video, and have a beautiful full moon in Aries tonight. Bye-bye.